Hi students, welcome back. Hope you all are safe. Today I am going to give you a recap of the old chapter Properties of Matter which we discussed so far. In our first video of chemistry, I gave you an introduction to chemistry and we first discussed about matter. Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. Then we discussed about the states of matter, solid, liquid, gas, and the fourth state of matter is plasma, and fifth and sixth state of matter is Bose-Einstein condensate and fermionic condensate respectively. These states can be generated only in laboratories. Then we discussed about the properties of three states of matter in solid state. What are the properties? Yes, it has a fixed shape and fixed volume. It is incompressible, it is rigid, and it do not fill the container completely. And about the liquid state, it has no definite shape, it takes the shape of the container. But it has a fixed volume, it's incompressible, and it is fluid. That means it can flow, and it do not fill the container completely. And about gas, it has no definite shape, it has no fixed volume, but it can be compressed, it can spread easily, it can fill the container completely. And we also discussed about the distance between the particles, force of attraction, and the energy of particles of the three states of matter. After that, we discussed about the transformation of states of matter, liquefaction, vaporization, condensation, solidification, and sublimation. Liquefaction is a process in which a solid substance becomes a liquid. For example, ice melts into water. The next one is vaporization. By this process, a liquid becomes gas. When the temperature increases, the rate of evaporation increases. The molecules on the surface of the liquid are thus changed into gaseous state. Collecting salt from seawater is an example for this process. The next one is condensation. A gas becomes a liquid on cooling. This process is known as condensation. The next process is sublimation. In this process, a solid, when heated, directly changes into gas without melting into liquid. An example for sublimation is camphor, naphthalene balls, etc. And next we discussed about diffusion. It is the reason behind the spreading of hot food, smell of flowers, spreading of smell of fruits, etc. So what is it? Yes, it is diffusion. Diffusion is the spontaneous mixing of different particles having the freedom of movement. After that, we discussed about pure substances and mixtures. Pure substances are materials made of particles of identical nature. And about mixtures, the substance made of particles of different nature are called mixtures. Then we studied about the separation of mixtures. Why do we need to separate components of a mixture? Yes, components of a mixture should be separated because some components may not be useful or may spoil the substance. So separation is essential. The first one is filtration. Filtration is used when separating a solid substance from a fluid by passing through a porous material such as a type of filter. The next type of separation is winnowing. Winnowing is a traditional method done by repeatedly tossing the grain up into a light wind which gradually blows the lighter chaff away. Evaporation involves heating a solution until the liquid turns to gases and leaves the solids behind. Next method we discussed is distillation. When one component of the mixture is volatile and the other do not vaporize under the same condition, they can be separated by distillation. Fractional distillation, it is the method of separating miscible liquid having very small difference in their boiling point. Do you know the difference between distillation and fractional distillation? Yes, you are right. Distillation is used to separate the components from a mixture of liquid substances, but there should be substantial difference in the boiling points of the components. If the difference is very small, fractional distillation is used. Next, we discussed about separating funnel. Separating funnel is an apparatus used for separating immiscible liquids from their mixture. Next is sublimation, the process in which a solid, when heated, changes directly into gas without melting into liquid is called sublimation. This method can be used to separate from the components which have the property of sublimation from the mixture. After that, we discussed about centrifugation. It's a method for separating components from a mixture based on the difference in the mass of particles. Separating butter from curd, separating blood cells from blood samples, etc. are the examples of centrifugation. And finally, we discussed about chromatography. It is the method used to separate more than one solute dissolved in the same solvent. Example, separating components of dye, separating poison from blood. So students, these are the points we discussed in this chapter, properties of matter. Watch the videos carefully and study it well. Also write the notes. Prepare well for your exams. Thank you.